If you're a hairdresser and you're watching this, I apologize. Welcome to my channel. Is it just me or does this video feel like old school YouTube? I'm like sitting on a chair, I've got my lighting, my camera set up, a mirror like behind me so I can see what I'm doing. It just feels very like makeup YouTube era, and I know that's still like a thing, but oh my gosh, when I was growing up, it was all about the makeup YouTubers like Shani Grimmon, Michael Finch. I used to watch those religiously and I used to like try and copy them. But anyway, okay guys, so back to what my head is naturally looking like at this moment. I washed it last night. I do want to put a little disclaimer. I have no idea how to do hair, but there is one style that I can do and I do it all the time because it's literally the only one that works for me, unless I just slick my hair back in like a ponytail or a bun. But this is like a Matilda Djerf kind of hairstyle. I have like got bangs cut. They're not like short bangs, but they like go to here. So it kind of works for me. I'm gonna show you how I achieve that Matilda Djerf style. Maybe I'll pop a photo up on the screen for you so you can see what I'm talking about. But yeah, I'm not a hairdresser, I have no idea what I'm doing. This just works for me. It's pretty universal. I am lazy and when I wash my hair, I do not dry it straight away. So last night I did go to sleep with wet hair. I did brush it. I brushed it and put like a little treatment in it, but I went to sleep with wet hair. So this is the outcome. So I'm just gonna get a brush, any brush. This is my brush, it's got hair in it. It's been used. I have a real issue with looking at like the screen finder and into the camera lens, and I'm not sure what, I really don't know. It's kind of like when you're not sure whether to look someone in the eyes when you're speaking to them or not. It kind of feels like that. But anyway, so I'm just gonna brush out my head. I have left this for quite a while because it's kind of later in the morning, but normally when I wake up, it's still a little bit damp. And when I do dry it, I use the Bondi. This is not any, none of this is sponsored, by the way. I have previously collaborated with Bondi Boost and they gave me this blow brush, which is life changing. My hair's like quite thin. I have a lot of it, so it's like a little bit flat. I kind of like dry it upwards to kind of give it a bit more volume. And that really helps, especially when it is a little bit damp. However, it's not that damp right now. Like I said, it did dry, but I'm gonna also spray some heat protectant spray, like up to you if you use that or not. I do like using it because I have bleached the shit out of my hair. Oh my God. Every time I say that I've bleached the shit out of my hair, it reminds me of that Jenna Marble, like that video that she made that first went viral when she like straightened her hair and she's like, I bleached the shit out of my hair and now that I've completely killed my hair. Or she says something like that. Hopefully I can put it in this video because it's freaking hilarious.
I bleached the absolute shit out of my hair.
It's such OG YouTube vibes. But yeah, okay, so now that I've done that, I'm just gonna section my hair off. Obviously it depends how much hair you have. I'm a little bit lazy. I just put my hair into two sections. So like the top layer and the bottom layer. And I've just got like a little claw clip to keep that up. Sorry if you see me looking like I'm trying to like look at myself in the mirror behind me. And then I brush that down. And then I'm just gonna get my blow brush. I use the higher setting for this. Before I turn it on, I'll just show you how I do it. So I go down and then I kind of twirl it. My hair's pretty dead straight, but just to give it a bit more like volume, a little bit more of like a way towards the ends. Obviously it's not on right now, but it does work better if your hair is a little bit more wet, but I'm still gonna use this anyway to make sure it's all really dried. The heat protectant's a little bit drier, so it curls a bit better, and to put some volume in, especially with the top pieces. So I'm gonna go ahead and use that. I'll put it in fast motion so you're not sitting there for bloody hours. Okay, let's go. Okay, so they're fully dried, those bottom bits. So I'm just gonna go in now. I'm still gonna leave the top and I'm gonna dry and then curl that at the same time. So I'm just doing the bottom layer for the moment. But now I'm gonna go in with this GHD wand. I'll put the links for everything that I use below if you wanna grab any of them. So this one I find is better because it doesn't have like the clip. I feel like the clip can leave marks in your hair when you're using like a clip to clip it. Instead, it's got like the cool tip that you can put your fingers on. You could use a glove, I can't be bothered. The one thing that's my pet peeve is when people like curl their hair, but then they leave like the end bit. And so then it has like a curl through the middle, but then the end has like a straight bit. Anyway, I'm not a fan of that. I do try and curl it quite a bit. I make it like very curly to begin with. See, my terminology is absolutely cooked. If you're a hairdresser and you're watching this, I apologize. But yeah, I try and do like quite tight curls and then I let them drop because they do drop. And then I find that even when I do my hair for a night out on like a Saturday, the next morning on a Sunday when I wake up, I'll love my hair that day. It'll be so nice because I've like slept in it and the curls have kind of like relaxed a bit. They do still relax after I curl them, but I'll show you and show you what it looks like. But yeah, I'm gonna go in with strands. I'm gonna section off my hair into two bits and I work from like the very back bit of my head. And I do it with pieces about this big. And then I get the wand, place it towards the top, and I point the rod upwards because that will give you like a tighter curl, I believe. Oh, I don't wanna burn myself, I can't see anything. Get pretty close. If you've got fake nails, like it's good because you can kind of touch the hot bit and not feel anything, but just be really careful, obviously, with this bit. So I'll do each individual piece. So then I'll pull it out and kind of like hold it up in the curl. Because whilst the curl is still hot, the hair is still like setting in its shape. So if I yanked it out and pulled it straight, it could set straight instead of curly. So I just keep that up, hold it a little bit, let it cool down. These bits don't matter as much because I find they hold. It's more the front bits that I'm more careful with. And then I just chuck it over my shoulder and then keep working all the way forwards. And then I go and do the other side. Okay, I'm gonna take this part down now. These to the back, the front parts. I'm gonna get my brush. And then I'm gonna get my Bondi Boost blow brush and I'm gonna dry this off. And it kind of straightens it a little bit as well, which makes the curl look nicer. And then I'm gonna blow my fringe upwards and then clip that as well. It's very hard to communicate it. I'll just show you. You could probably also do this bit with a hairdryer and a brush, like a round brush if you like. I am not that skilled. So I'm just grabbing like a smaller clip. And I'm just gonna get my very, very front bits, like my bangs, and I'm just gonna clip that up, blow dry them up one more time. It's really hard to see, so I'm just gonna look in the mirror and find them because I don't wanna grab the longer bits. I'm gonna twist that and leave that bit for later. The screen finder is such a small mirror to look in. And I'm gonna bring those front bits back to the front, make sure I'm not picking up any curls. It's a lot more simple when I'm doing it just in my bathroom, I feel. And then I'm gonna grab those front bits that haven't yet been curled and go back in with my GHD wand. Okay, so both sides are curled now. They do look a little bit crazy, but don't stress. It's not gonna look like that at the end. So now comes the fringe part. So if you can see, like if you do have bangs or even just like front, like shorter front parts, this is what I do to curl them. I find it really hard to curl them with like a curling wand. So I actually get a straightener. I find this the most effective way. I've tried doing the thing where you get a roller and put heat on it, but that doesn't work, it just falls out. So just get whatever straightener you have. I literally have this super random VS Salon straightener from years ago. Do you know how you just have like one straightener and then you just, I don't know, you just keep using it? But I am going to use that on my fringe. So I'm just gonna unclip my fringe and I'm gonna brush it up one last time. Depending on where you part your hair, that's where you want to separate it. I part my hair in the center. I really like having clean curls, so I do brush. I brush my hair so much. This is gonna be hard to do on a camera, but you get your straightener, you grab your piece of hair, and then you go just above, clamp it here, and then bring it out to the side, and then curl it just once over that all the way to the end. And then you just want to hold that nice and tight to your head just so it keeps that position where it kind of like comes down like that. I have no words or terminology for what I'm doing, but basically, yeah, you curl each piece of hair on a diagonal and then I just hold it to my head so it stays put until it's cold, so it's set. So your hair won't be set while it's hot, it does set when it's cold, so you just wanna make sure that it's in the position that you want it to be whilst it's hot. Like, look at that little ringlet. Hold that to her head and we're just gonna keep it there. Like I said, it's not gonna look like this. Anyway, now we're gonna get the other side and do exactly the same thing. Okay, so that is done with like the heating tools and stuff. Obviously you can go back and touch it up if you need to. Sometimes I do that. This is not the finished product. We are now gonna brush it out. I just wanted to say, I know my hairdresser uses like this powder, which makes it a bit more voluminous. So if you have that, definitely add that and put it under like these bits. I'll link that powder that she uses below when she does my hair. And then there's also like shine sprays that you can use, hairspray to keep it in place. I don't actually use anything. I literally don't use anything. If I had the shine spray or the powder, I would. I need to get some of that. It does make your hair look nice and shiny, and then the powder's for the volume, like I said. So I will link those below for you. However, I don't set it with hairspray, and I think it's just because I don't like the look of it set with hairspray. It kind of like makes it all stiff, and I don't know, it doesn't look really nice in my hair. If you haven't ever bleached your hair, it's gonna struggle to like keep the curls or the waves in, depending on the type of hair that you have. So you might need to use hairspray, but I don't. And then it does fall out quite a bit, but I kind of like it a little bit more wavy, not crazy curly like this. But yeah, literally just grab any brush you can use. I probably would recommend like a soft bristle brush as opposed to just like a normal paddle brush to brush out the curls. So you just wanna go really light-handed and be really careful. Let's do it. And then with the fringe bits, I actually brush it backwards as opposed to brushing it down straight. I brush them backwards to get more of that like wispy look. Sometimes they don't work and I have to do them again, but I think we're good. But there we go, that is it. I just wanna say that it is raining today and my hair normally does like a weird kind of frizzy thing when it is raining, but that is the Matilda Djerf, the only hairstyle I use and no tutorial. This is my go-to. It is what you guys have requested so much, especially over on my Instagram and TikTok, because it's literally what I have all the time. If you do wanna like go back through and put some more curls in it the next day, can. Normally I find it's pretty okay on my hair. I probably would recommend hairspraying it at least the first couple times, just so it does stay. But yeah, that is the hair tutorial and I will see you guys in my next video. Make sure to comment below and request what you would like to see next. Okay, bye.